Helena, sonhei com você essa noite. Você era suave, andava pelas ruas de Nova York com uma blusa de seda. Procuro chegar perto, encostar, sentir seu cheiro. Mas quando vejo, você tá em cima de um muro, enroscada no emaranhado de fios elétricos. Olho de novo e vejo que sou eu que tô em cima do muro. Eu mexo nos fios, buscando tomar um choque. E caio do muro bem alto e morro.
Helena, a film about the persistence of memories, the irreversibility of a loss. This documentary is born of the desire to withdraw a sister of the world of the forgotten ones. Helena, a young Brazilian woman who moves to New York in order to follow her dream of becoming a movie actress. But while reaching that goal, she's submerged in a really depressive state of mind, dark and sad days, and finally, she killed herself, leaving a 7-year-old sister, Petra.
How old are you?
20.
20. And how tall are you?
5'9 and a half.
Okay. You were born in Brazil?
I was born in Brazil.
Uh-huh.
And I've been here almost a year and a half now.
What brought you to come to the United States?
I was doing theater there since I was 14 years old. And then the possibilities in Brazil are like either you continue doing theater, which, I mean, there are very few productions, or you do soaps.
Uh-huh.
I was invited to do, I mean, after a while that I was in theater, but I don't really like it.
The seed of the idea for this film was born when Petra was 18 years old and working as an actress in São Paulo. One day, she decided to look her diaries when suddenly she found a notebook that had never seen before. As she began to read, she saw written her own desires and insecurities, her own thought about art and love, the breathless sensation that she had experienced but she has never been able to express. The writing belonged to her sister Helena, from a few months before she died. She committed suicide in 1990, in New York, when she was 20. This documentary is a search of her sister, as well as for her. Petra says that another reason for doing this movie is that there were few films, especially in Brazil, about women navigating the transition from adolescence to adulthood. This is a path of 65 years in Brazil, three woman generation, our three woman characters. Helena, who encountered a Brazil struck by AIDS and a barren artistic landscape in the 1980s. Petra, coming of age at a time when Brazil was booming with economic and artistic resources. And a mom who fought against the military dictatorship in Brazil. This is an attempt at this memory, both historical memory of the military dictatorship and its psychological aftermaths. Documentaries address the world in which we live, rather than a world imagined by the filmmaker. Bill Nichols, an American documentary theorist, distinguished between documentary styles and developed six modes: poetic, expository, participatory, observational, reflexive, and performative. I would say that this documentary is in the participatory mode. The researcher goes into the field, participates in the lives of others, gains a corporeal and visceral feed for what life in a given context is like, and then reflects on this experience. explore the relationship between the filmmaker and the participants. They usually are driven by conversations or interviews with the filmmaker directly involved in front of the camera.
I'm not doing so well. And I said, no, it's okay, Elena, I'll come and get you. It's not a problem, I'll come and get you.
Ela estava sentada na cama, do outro lado, eu sentei, aí que ela falou, arte para mim é tudo, sem a arte, eu prefiro morrer. Se minha arte, se eu não consigo fazer arte. Melhor morrer.
The director of this documentary has a strong connection with this story. It is a personal story. But to spread a message about the taboo of suicide. Moreover, even though depression is rampantly spreading throughout Brazil as in the United States, Petra had never seen a Brazilian film that truly portrayed silent suffering. The World Health Organization recognized suicide as a public health priority. Increased knowledge of suicide risk factors is needed in order to be able to adopt effective prevention strategies. Suicide in Brazil is something that is not talked about and that is very common in young women. We can define this documentary as a road movie of the mind, dense, poetic, and personal, made of fragments from home movies, diary entries, photos, excerpts from letters narrated by Elena Costa in a tone of dreamy sadness, and recreated moments of the characters.
Todo mundo tinha saído. O rapaz tocou em todos os apartamentos para ver se alguém abria para ele salvar a Elena. Mas ninguém veio. Não tinha ninguém aqui.
The camera is in constantly movement. Close-ups, short, medium shots. There are barely long shots. The images sometimes are blurry. It transmits a more intimate vision. Nearer and diffuse, like the memory that Petra has of her sister. The narrative structure of this film starts with the presentation of Elena. Everything is okay. We see the artistic personality that Elena has, her dream of becoming an actress and her relationship with Petra. But things started to change when their parents get divorced. She distanced herself. At the time of being part of a theater group, she gets obsessed with perfection. And that is what kills her. When she committed suicide, the movie started to get focused on how this affects her family, especially how this affected psychologically to Petra.
Me olho no espelho e não vejo nada atrás dos meus olhos.
Definitely, the final of the movie is a very emotional moment that invites the spectator to think over the feeling of a family and to symbolize the liberation of the director. Elena is an Ophelia. There are many Ophelias wandering the streets of this world, and Petra wanted to make a film about them. Girls who, in becoming women, find themselves drowning in the river of desires and sensations, of excesses of feelings and wants. Too often, they submerge themselves without ever being able to come back to the surface.
I turn to water.
In this film, she set out to recover them, to bring them back to the surface.